If you are not going to be using Interface Configuration Utility to manage this interface, you can manually, from the command prompt, install the interface to run as a service. To be honest, on a scale of 1 to 10, where 10 is the most important, I think this is about a 2 in importance. Very few people need to do this, to actually use this from the command prompt, but this is the older way. I'll show you how to do this. You may have actually had folks do this at your site already. The way you would do this is you would go ahead and type the name of the executable, that's the interface, with the dash install switch. And then you would choose a bunch of options, options like auto, display, and the name, dependencies, service ID, etc. So those are some of the switches, and when you're finished, you will see that that interface has been configured as a service. Now again, if you're not familiar with services, don't worry. This is a brand new topic for most people who are not used to managing Windows resources. Let me show you what I mean by service. I'm going to go into Control Panel, and within Control Panel, choose Administrative Tools. I'm going to look at the Services applet, and let's make this a little bigger. The Services applet, it's the applet that shows you what services are currently installed. So services like TCP/IP that run all the time, whether you're logged in or not, that's what we mean by service. It's an application that's going to run really apart from any user who started it. So for example, the PI services, if you look at a lot of these PI services on the server side, these are things that are going to be run automatically. Now actually PI is installed on this machine, but it's not currently running. That's why you see none of these are running here. I'm using this as an interface node now. Now let's take a look at the PI SNMP interface. It is not currently listed as a service. We see some other interfaces listed, PI Perfmon, PI Ping, etc. PI, I think the OPC interface is here. Yeah, there they are. So how do I add a service if I don't do it through Interface Configuration Utility? Well, what you would do is first launch a copy of, or launch a command window. I'm going to go ahead and type in CMD. This is a command window, and from here I'm going to change directories to the directory that has the interface. So I'll change to program files, change directory to PyPC, let me change directory to interfaces, and now I'd like to use as an example, it's called the SNMP interface. Yes, if we look at this directory, let me go over and look at it here. This is under interfaces, it is called SNMP, and this is the name of the executable, PI SNMP. Well, that is not currently installed as a service, so I can install it to run as a service by doing PI SNMP.exe-install, and now I can choose whatever whatever install options I want. For example, I'd like this to automatically start whenever the operating system starts. And I can also specify that the dependency, there's a dependency on the process called BuffServe, or the service called BuffServe. And what that did is it just installed this as a service. As you see, we're using the interface itself to install itself as a service. And now if we switch over to the services applet, if I refresh this, I don't see PI SNMP yet, but if I refresh this, there it is. Here's the service name. It's called PI SNMP. As you can see, it's set for auto start. So that's the old-fashioned way of doing it, I guess I should say, the command prompt way of doing this. We'll show you in just a few minutes how to set this up using Interface Configuration Utility.